Good morning, everybody. Welcome to Bar Where You Are. Today, it's coming from stormy Orlando. I'm sorry, guys, we've got to be under the cover today. For those of you that didn't meet me last week, my name's Sarah, and I am an instructor at the Bar Method in Winter Park, which obviously is in Orlando. I'm also a national coach and a trainer. Oh, you hear the thunder? There it is. The tools that you will need today for class include a mat, a yoga mat, if you'd like one for your feet, and a couple of throw cushions, maybe a towel rolled up, a strap, or I'm using a belt, so something of that ilk. And then of course, you will need your support, whether it's a chair or a countertop, something sturdy for you to hold on to a little later on in class. Shall we get started? I'm excited to work out with you today. It's all about strength for curl, okay? So today we're going to work your deep, deep abs, your transverse abdominis. They are the lowest layer of muscles. You have to breathe to work them and access them because they are attached only to your diaphragm. Are you ready? Come on, let's do it. Put your hands on your hips and lift your knees just to hip height. Lift, lift, lift. Point your toes directly down towards the floor. Avoid tucking your feet. You deserve that stretch in your shins and your hamstrings. If it's comfortable for your shoulders, just leave your hands on your hips here. Or you could bring your arms up and make fists. Punch forwards as you lift your knees. Punch, punch. And be sure your arms are maybe a little bit wider than your shoulders so you can wake up your chest muscles and your biceps. Keep going, guys. Hopefully, you've all had time to go to barmethod.com and check out your local studios. Please do that. They are doing an amazing job of giving you a variety of classes to join in and also some fun activities to do too. All right, last 10 leg lifts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, release. Come and find your support. I like to put my chair slightly on my yoga mat. It avoids it from slipping. And turn to face me. Just be at half arm's length from the bar with your feet parallel and hips width apart. Straighten your legs, squeeze your glutes, pull your abs in, lock your shoulders down, and lift your heels all the way up. Lift them up and down, up and down. Get them as high as you comfortably can and bring them all the way down to the floor in between. That's gonna lengthen out your calf muscle as well as tone it. It's also strengthening your knees. You guys keep going. I'm gonna give you a different viewpoint here. So you see you're straight up and down. We lift up out of your torso. You'll hear us talk a lot about perfecting your posture in Bar Method. If you have any issues with the balls of your feet, you can lift up a little bit less if that's more comfortable for you. Lift quickly, up, down, up, down. Keep going. How you doing? If you want to balance, go for it. You can put both hands on your waist or lift your arms up above you. 10 more, then a hold. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, hold at the top, re-squeeze, pull your belly button up and in. I like to balance with my arms up. It gives me a little extra lift. And if you bend forward at your waist slightly, it's so much easier to balance. Hold for the last 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Lower your heels, face your support. Step back with one foot. Press your heel all the way down into the floor. And then tilt your pelvis under a little bit. You feel that stretch in your calf muscle now, right? And then open up your chest to release everything in your upper body as well. Change sides. Step back with your other foot. Tilt your pelvis under. Bend your knee deeply. You'll feel a nice release down your quads too. All right, ready for some thigh work. Open your legs out to a wide second position. Keep that half arm's distance from the bar. bend your knees. This is where you adjust. Maybe walk your feet out a little bit more. Track your ankles under the line of your knees. Turn your toes to be in line with your kneecaps. And then bring your shoulders back and over your hips. Again, it's that beautiful posture, remember that. Just hold it here. Squeeze your bottom tightly. Avoid tilting your pelvis here. Allow that natural curve in your back to happen. Just ease your seat. You wanna rev it up. You can pull your inner thighs back. Maybe balance with your hands in prayer. Breathe. Close your eyes if you want to. Breathe. This is where you mentally set the tone for the rest of class. So just tune into your body, see how you're feeling. Hold this position, press down an inch, down and up. Resist the temptation to make it a big movement. The smaller, the better in bar method. It keeps you in the muscle, makes it more challenging for sure. Push against your palms. That way you're working your pec muscles, your chest, your biceps, and your upper back too. It's like a BOGO. Buy one, get one free. I love those, don't you? All right, how you doing, guys? I hope you're holding up in there. If you'd like more of a challenge, you could just flex your feet and lift your toes slightly off the floor, like this. Oh, wow, now you feel it in your hamstrings even more, right? Press down quickly, down, down, down. I'm gonna join you back in prayer. Why not? You guys are working hard. I better work hard too, right? All right, keep going. Focus on your breath. This is the point where your mind's saying, oh, I'm not sure if I really want to do this today, but you can. Remember those deep abs. You have to breathe to work them. You've got eight more. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Just hold it still at the bottom. Breathe, breathe. Your breath helps you to get through it here. You could stay with your hands in prayer, or you could reach your arms up above you. And if you do that, bring them forward a little bit. Protect your shoulders, and then engage your trap muscles. These muscles right here, pull them down. They help to give you gorgeous posture as you go throughout your day. Squeeze your bottom, squeeze, squeeze. Are you done yet? I bet you are. I know I am. Not shaking. Last 15. One, two. Then you're going to stretch. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, five more. One, two, three, four. Come on up. Face your support again. Take one ankle and keep your knee underneath your hip. Tilt your pelvis again. Roll it under. Do you feel that stretch in your quad now? Now lift up through your abs. And if you want to, you can balance. Press your foot more into your hand so that you can get that best stretch. And then change legs, stretch it out. I'm gonna adjust the music. I lost my amp there. Enough of the stretching. It's time for push-ups. Oh, you got a good little breather there before that happened. Come on down. Place your hands underneath your shoulders. You can always do this at your support or at a wall if you need to. Keep your legs hips width apart. You can do these on your knees or the balls of your feet. Grip your glutes, pull your abs up. Separate your shoulder blades. Bend your elbows diagonally back towards your torso. Stop here. Think A letter. Letter A rather than letter T. The letter A, with your elbows angled back at 45 degrees, protects your shoulders. Strain your arms. You have 10 4-inch push-ups. Here we go. Press down and push up. Down, two, down, three. Keep going, push against the floor, use your breath again. Down, six, down, seven, down, eight, down, nine, One more. Come to your forearms for a plank series. This is like my favorite plank set to do. Clasp your fists, or you can just turn your palms in. Keep your legs hips width apart. Re-squeeze your seat, pull your navel up, draw your shoulders down. Exhale sharply, exhale, exhale. All right, listen carefully, guys. Pivot your left forearm so it's underneath you. Cross your right foot behind your left, open to the right, and lift your right arm up. Push your top hip forward, pull your belly button back, and breathe. Exhale, exhale. You can always do this on your knees if it's too much on your feet. All of your weight should be on your right foot. Drop your shoulders down. Stay here. 10 more counts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Come back to a regular plank. Reset yourselves. Refocus. Ready to go the other way. Place your right forearm underneath you. Flush your left foot behind your right. And turn. You guys keep going. Pull your top hip forward. This is a great way to strengthen your shoulders, your obliques, your toning from your hip down towards your heel. Hold it here for 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Come back to a regular plank again. Hold it here. You've got this. You're mentally and physically stronger. Last 10 counts. 1, 2, keep going. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Release. Do a puppy stretch. Stay up high, but reach your arms long out in front of you. Press your chest to the floor. Feel that release. You deserve it. That was hard work, wasn't it? All right. You've got some more push-ups. They're like the most economic workout exercise you can do. They're free, right? And weight-bearing. Here we go. Place your hands down. Separate your shoulder blades. 10 full range. Begin. Press down. Push up. Down. 2. Keep going, guys. This is a great way to build up your bone density and increase your joint health. Down. 7. Down. 8. Down. 9. Do one more. Now sit back on your heels this time. Shoot back like a child's pose. Flip your palms up. Open them out wider than your shoulders. And tuck your chin. Just swing your feet round in front of you. You get an extra stretch here. This one's one of my favorites, a reclining twist. Lie down and hug your knees into your chest. Keep your thighs close to you. If you're pregnant, just stay sitting up and I'll show you what to do in a second. Otherwise, lower your knees down to one side. You can reach your opposite arm out and look that way. It's a great way to stretch out your low back and your glutes. Keep going, guys. If you're pregnant, you can just sit up and reach over to the side. Everybody come back to center for the reclining twist. Go up and over the other way. You're lubricating and increasing all the hydration in your spinal discs when you do this. All right, come on up. It's time for high curl, one of my favorite ab exercises. If you're pregnant or you need a little extra support behind you, then take a couple of throw cushions. I like to use a rolled up towel. So it looks like this. And then come and sit down. Place your feet parallel and hips width apart. And put your towel right behind where your glutes are. If you've got throw cushions, just pull them in close to you so that your low back is supported. If you have any discomfort in your hips, you could bring your feet to a diamond shape. So you draw your heels together, flex your feet, and let your thighs open. Do what feels right for you. Okay, reach your arms up to a diagonal. Breathe in. Exhale, roll back to a 45 degree angle. You might need to just adjust your support a little bit. And then bend deeply your waist. This one makes me shake like immediately. Open your arms out a little wider. Pull your shoulders back and down. Keep gripping your glutes and your hamstrings. If you're not feeling it, go back a little bit more and then bend right at your waistline. Keep this position with your body. Hold on to your legs. Woo, you're just holding still. It's called high curl, but you're just staying still and breathing. Come back to that square position with your hands and push your palms together to activate your chest muscles. Hold for 8 more slow counts. Keep going. 1, 2, 3. Your heart rate's going up. That means you're burning lots of calories. 6, 7. Pull back onto your legs for a reset. Maybe shake out your head a little bit. Now here's a good one. Open your arms out to the side. Avoid throwing them back. Keep them forward a little bit so you can keep that bend at your waist. 6 more here. Breathe. 2, that's your transverse abdominis working. 5, hold back onto your legs. 1 more slow one, you ready? Lift your arms up for this one. Keep them just slightly forward of your shoulders. Re-bend at your waist. 6 more counts. 1, breathe. 2, I hope you're shaking as well. 4, 5, 6, that's it, hold back on. Now breathe quickly. Exhale, exhale. You're gonna feel that fire revving up in your torso. Bring your hands back to a prayer position and press your palms together. Push, push, 8 more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Reclaim your legs. Maybe slide your feet forward a little bit. Then go back a little bit more, re-bend. Bring your arms to the side, hold for 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Hold back on. Last one. You're training all your abs to pull in tight like a corset. Reach your arms up above you. Last 10. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Sit up. Good work, peeps. Place your hands behind you. Lift your chest. It's such a lovely release when you do this stretch. All right, low curl with your feet down is next. I need my throat cushions for this one. Again, you're not curling, you're holding still. You can, my cushions are a little bit wide, but if you can come down onto your elbows first, do that. Keep your feet parallel and hips width again. And then hold onto your legs. Can you see that your low back is down for this one? That's why it's called low curl. You're getting right into your six-pack muscles, but you're still working your deep, deep abs because you're holding still and breathing. Just holding on is a workout in itself. Your biceps are fired up, and your forearm muscles, look at these. And then if you pull your shoulders down, you're working your traps again, getting that stretch in your upper back, creating beautiful posture. Exhale quickly. Exhale, exhale. You can stay holding on if you want to, or if you want more of a challenge in your abs, let go for 20. 1, 2, keep going. 4, 5, keep breathing. 7, 8, 9. 10 more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Hold your legs again. Breathe. Now slow down your breath. You always find it is so yummy to go slower after you've gone quickly. Now if you go to one of your local studios, you will see your instructors going around and they will be helping you to engage your shoulders. Maybe give you a little extra support. It's all about keeping you safe in bar method. All right, reach your arms forward if you would like to for 10 slow breaths. 1, 2. Look down at your abs and see them pull down every time that you breathe. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Pull back onto your legs. Your last set here. Breathe quickly. finish how you started. Could you maybe press your tailbone down a little bit more? It's gonna lengthen out your low back, give you a beautiful stretch there. If you want to let go, go for it. Maybe reach your arms up a little bit higher. It makes it more challenging. You have to bend deeply at your waist. Last 15 counts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Last 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. Come on up and stretch it out again. Ooh, let's get your heart rate up again, shall we, before we go into the last set of curl. Favorite effective workout. It's push-ups. Maybe do them on the balls of your feet if you didn't the last couple of times. Place your hands down, keep your legs hips width apart, grip your glutes, pull your belly button up, ready, go for 10. Down, 1, down, 2, keep going. Down, 4, down, 5, down, 6, down, 7, you almost got it. Down, 9, last one. You've got your puppy stretch, reach your arms long in front of you. This is a great way to increase flexibility in your back while you stretch out your arms and chest. Sit back on your heels, turn your palms up, tuck your chin, get a stretch and release in your neck and shoulders. All right, last ab exercise of the day is straight leg clamp. Remember the towel that you used for high curl? Well, take it now. You can fold it in halves or in thirds, depending on how big and thick it is. And then you'll lie down and put this towel underneath your bottom. All right, take a hold of your thighs and lift your legs up. Point them up towards the ceiling. You don't have to straighten them. You can keep them slightly soft if you want to. And then you've got some choices with your arms. You can either place your hands behind your head and just allow your head to rest in your hands. Or if you have nice long arms, you can place your hands on opposite shoulders for little fox ears again. All right, or if you want to, if you've got shoulder issues like me, you can place your hands on your chest. Now tilt your pelvis towards your rib cage. All right, you feel your abs contract. Your lower back will stretch out. Bend and stretch your legs quickly. Stretch, stretch, stretch. Okay, and if you want to curl, lift your head and shoulders off the floor, turn slightly towards your left leg and curl there to work your oblique muscles. Curl, curl, curl. Keep going. Getting a nice stretch in your low back as you do this. You've got 10 more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Lower back down for a reset. Keep stretching your legs quickly. Stretch, stretch, stretch. All right, lift your head and shoulders off of the ground again. And then stretch towards your other leg. Stretch, curl, stretch, curl. If this is too much to curl, keep your head down and press your palms or the sides of your fists down into the floor. Woo, you're still gonna get it. A nice stretch in your low back and your abs. Do 10 more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Reset, lower your head down. It's your last one, are you ready? Slow down that bend and stretch. Bend, stretch. If you would like more of a challenge, lower your feet away from you so you can really target right underneath your waistline. Okay, when you're ready, lift your head and shoulders up and add the curl. Bend, stretch, curl. Bend, stretch, curl. You're on your second to last thing. Let your head look up towards the ceiling. Avoid any tension in your neck. You've got 5 more at this tempo. 1, 2, 3, 4. Speed it up. Stretch, curl, stretch, curl. You are there. Keep going, guys. It's your final push. Give it all you got. All right, last 10. 1, 2, 3, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Release. Bring your knees into your chest and just take your tail out of the way. Bring your knees in close. You get another reclining twist here. Now, if you're pregnant, sit up and just do the side to side stretch. Lower your knees down. Extend the other arm out if you wish. And you have an option here to extend your bottom leg down to deepen the stretch in your low back. Anytime you do a twist, it's a great detoxifier. You're massaging your inner organs. Lift up and over the other way. All right, bring your knees back in towards you. And guess what? Got one more plank. You're not getting away lightly today. Come onto your forearms. Just a regular plank this time, I promise. Nothing fancy. Keep your legs hips width apart. Regrip your glutes, pull your belly button up, and then shift your weight forward a little bit. Ooh, it intensifies the feelings in your abs. Squeeze your seat. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Feel like you're pulling your glutes towards each other rather than rolling your pelvis under. You're working your glutes even more. That boosts your caloric burn to make it the most effective workout for you. Keep lifting up through your rib cage. Avoid sinking down into your shoulders. You've got this. Last 15. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Last 5 and lots of stretches. 2, 3, 4. Release. Do a puppy stretch. Reach your arms long in front of you. I'm going to change the music to something more relaxing. And then sit back on your heels, flip your palms up, open your arms wider again, tuck your chin. Come on to all fours so that you can arch them around your back. Place your hands under your shoulders, keep your legs hips width apart, and then as you exhale, pull your belly button up, hunch your back, tuck your chin, and then inhale, lower your belly down. You can come to neutral, or if you want to get a deeper stretch, you can lift your chest a little bit. Do that again. Exhale, just move at your own pace. This is a great way to come back to your breath again, so you can calm your mind, especially after you've had technical difficulties with your music, right? Thanks for sticking with me, guys. All right, come to a neutral position. And then come and sit back on your heels again in a child's pose. Reach your arms out long in front of you. And then you can reach your arms back behind you. And just allow your head to drop forward. Allow everything in your upper back just to open up and release. Release your postural muscles. You've worked very hard on strengthening them today. All right, slowly roll on up. One last stretch, the strap stretch. So find your belt, your tie, whatever you're using today. Lie down on your back. And then place your strap over the balls of your feet. Bend your knees a little bit, breathe in. Exhale, straighten your legs all the way. Press your bottom down. That gives you a nice release down your low back as well as your hamstrings. Allow one leg to come out of your strap. Lower it to the floor. Keep both legs straight and then your feet flexed. This will taper down your legs, your upper thighs. Pull your leg a little closer. Bend your top knee, breathe in. Exhale, try and keep your thigh where it is and breathe, straighten your leg. And if you want to, you can take your leg out to the side a little bit. It's a wonderful way to increase your flexibility and range of motion in this final stretch. Bring your leg back up. And switch sides. Switch legs. Flex your feet. Pull your leg a little closer to you. Use your biceps. You work them out really hard, so they're going to help you a lot. Bend your top knee slightly. your leg where it is and we straighten. Take your leg out to the side, just a little bit. There we go. Try and keep your opposite hip down. That'll lengthen all down your inner thigh muscles. Bring your leg back up. Bring your left leg into your strap or your other leg. Bend your knees, breathe in. One more time. Exhale, straighten your legs. Keep your tailbone down, but you can lift your chest slightly if you want to deepen the stretch in your back. Lower down. Bring your knees to your chest. Roll over onto one side. Come on up to sitting. Face me. Give me a big smile. Hasn't your mood elevated from working out? Take a deep breath in. Reach up towards the sky. Through your fingertips. Feel that power. Exhale. Push all the air out. You worked extremely hard today. Be proud of yourselves. Take one more deep breath in. Feel that lovely lifted feeling. Hold on to it. Just exhale, let any stress or tension go. I salute you, I applaud you. Thank you so much for working out with me today. Come back and see us tomorrow at the same time. Lauren will be dishing up something scrumptious for you. And please, 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 go to barmethod.com. Find your local studio and join them. Support small, support local. They're offering some amazing classes and they are working so hard to keep you all stress-free, sane and happy and fit. Nice to see you guys. Have a wonderful Monday.